Hey guys, Dr. Carlo here. So I came to work today and I found this tape to our doctor station. So let's talk about it. Strokes, do not forget. So it's been an issue, we're forgetting to do some things. And this is a reminder, a highlight of the importance of these elements that we're gonna discuss. Any patient with neurological signs and symptoms, theoretically, eventually, they could rule in for stroke. And if they rule in for stroke, then it's gonna go back and be analyzed for all these little core measures or things that we have to do on stroke patients. So that is why we have a very low threshold to call a code neuro on a patient who passed out, who just has sudden onset vertigo, who might be a little altered. Even though the explanation for that might be hypoglycemia or a fever or something else, initially we don't know. And ultimately a patient may rule in for a stroke. So if they rule in for a stroke, it's gonna be analyzed for stroke, and this is why it's gonna be a code neuro. And if they meet a code neuro, they need a dysphagia screening and a NIH stroke scale within 15 minutes. And you guys know, if not already, that if you don't do it and they get admitted, you're gonna get an email from our liaison for stroke saying, you gotta document these things on the chart today. Because if we don't do it, what's that word I'm looking for? Currently with the patient visit, contemporaneously, that's the word, contemporaneously with the patient's visit, then we might have a fallout in our documentation. So this needs to be done contemporaneously with the patient care. So ideally, right then and there, NIHSS score within 15 minutes and dysphagia screening. Of course, if you use the code NEURO order set, the dysphagia screening is ordered, it will be done by nursing and you're off the hook. But the NIHSS stroke scale is up to you to document. Now, if you do a code NEURO, it'll be seen by Neuro, and Neuro will do an NIH score, so you can just take their score and put it in. But the problem is, rarely will that be done within 50 minutes, so you really should do your own NIH score. So a code Neuro score, we already explained, any new neurological symptoms, any suggestive stroke is going to be called. Stat physician assessment, we need to be in that room for a code Neuro within the first 10 minutes of the patient's arrival. Now I understand, sometimes we have a back of a patient, we have a chest pain, we might have multiple code Neuros. So with every possibility, the best effort you can, gotta get there quickly to see those patients. It's kind of embarrassing that the teleneuro gets there before you actually get there. And then you get your NIH score, of course the CATs are gonna be bad. Blood work will be done by the phlebotomist, so that'll be done very quickly. CT scan by CT, so usually within 10 minutes of arrival and stuff like that. It is very important that your documentation shows very specifically last known well. When was the last time that patient was well? And this is very important. It might have been that they woke up like this, or we don't know when the last known well is, but you need to write that specifically for it to have a complete documentation. Of course, contact teleneurology. But what I have to say about that is that that's gonna be triggered by the unit secretary because a code neuro was called. What you need to have in your mind is that if it's patient doesn't meet criteria for TPA, so it's not a code neuro that is stat, or you need an emergent neuro evaluation, then you can tell them it's a non-emergent consult. That way it can happen today or it can happen tomorrow morning if the patient's getting admitted. If the patient has been discharged, then it doesn't matter. Like for example, someone comes numb in the face, you go in and it's Bell's palsy. But you can cancel a code neuro, but the bottom line is then you gotta tell the unit secretary so they know about that. So there's a difference between emergent stat consult, the one that needs to happen right away, so we'll give TPA to and we're within the times, and the one that's non-emergent can happen any time after that. For TPA administration, of course, we need all the blood work done and send out, but that's not up to us. That'll be up to phlebotomy and the nursing. An EKG needs to be done and needs to be done within 45 minutes. And then TPA decision. Your documentation needs to say no TPA because patient out of the window, patient with too high of an NIHSS score, patient with a mild deficit that's resolving, or patient had a recent stroke, whatever it is. Even if it seems obvious that this patient clearly does not meet TPA criteria, you need to write the phrase, no TPA given because. So any code neuro or any patient is getting admitted with a neurological finding, somebody comes in with a numb finger, numb hand, or difficulty of speech, they might rule in for stroke. And actually, this might seem kind of silly, but they come in for chest pain, they come for some other symptom, palpitations, they end up getting a carotid ultrasound. The carotid ultrasound shows a critical stenosis. They're ultimately gonna be coded as a stroke upon discharge. And if they get coded as a stroke, then go look back at all of this. So you need to make sure that you're doing that documentation. And if you don't, then you're going to get harassed by me, by Jen Hartness, and by all the stroke liaison personnel who are going to analyze the chart and look for these things. If they're not there, then we're going to get an email. You got to do it today. You got to do it before the patient's discharged, or else we have a core measure fall out, and that's kind of a big deal. So here's a little bit of the flow process of documentation issues with code strokes, and I hope you learned something from it. Bye-bye.